You have put your name or your email address into our mailing list, you will be receiving an email that will give you instructions on how to participate in our open house tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so that you can get a deeper and more insightful knowledge of what we do here at the university.
Beautiful. And your open house is locally. It's where you're located, correct?
Right. It's actually on the email. It's over the computer. The open house will be a cyber open house. So they'll have to have their emails, and once they've opened their emails up, all they have to do is follow the instructions, and then it will open up into our website, and we will have a PowerPoint presentation there for them. And they can follow along and participate. And they will have also a phone number to call in to a conference call. And when they call into the conference call, we can speak to them and let them know more about it as we do. And then there's questions and answers after we've done our presentation. There you will hear Dr. Nalani speak. You'll also hear Dr. Rocchetti speak, and you will hear me speak.
Wonderful. Well, I'm definitely going to commit to, joining and listening in. And, people need to be on your mailing list. And how do they find that mailing list, Dr. Valentine? Is it located on your site?
Yes. Just go to uksnow.org, and that will open up into our university's website. When you see there, right there on the homepage, at the bottom right, they will say join our email or join our address, or I'm not sure what's there. My wife put together everything. But it will say join our mailing list, I believe. And right there, there's a big white box right there. And all you do is put your email in, join, and then we will send out another invitation. She's already sent it out to the members of our already on the email list. So I'm inviting people who are here on your show, Conscious Plat, and for those of you who want to participate, just put your email address, go up to our website at the university, uksnow.org, put in your email address, and we'll send you an invitation.
That is wonderful, and I will definitely do that following the program. And I did type the website address in the chat room so people can see that, and that is uksnow.org. So I did post that information, Dr. Valentine.
Thank you so much.
No problem. More than welcome to do that. All right. Well, we're down to 37 minutes in the program. Again, the call-in number is 917-388-4620. And I didn't get the question from the brother that tried to call in. Sorry, he was having difficulties. But I do thank the callers that have called in so far. And we still have some time to get a few quick questions in. And while we're waiting, Dr. Valentine, you did speak a little bit earlier about 2012 and that sort of thing. I remember on one of the programs that you were on, my program actually, you spoke about planetoids and, you know, different things heading toward the Earth and those types of things. Can you kind of expound on some of the things that we are to expect, you know, in this era, this time era?
Yeah, that's a good question. Back in the early 90s, before it turned 2000 as well, I spoke on the fact that our entire solar system, as well as the our universe itself, everything is traveling. Nothing is standing still. And that as we travel, I said that after 2000, the area of the universe that we are going to be entering is going to be dense with planets that we have not seen, or the past observers and astronomers from this paradigm of Europeans, the European paradigm, they've not seen it and have not cataloged it in their reality. But our ancestors have already cataloged these planets and cataloged all the different types of skies that we've got in the different parts of the universes the word galaxy was the word I was looking for. Our galaxy is traveling inside of these universes and then many other universes. And what has happened is as we are traveling around in this carousel of light, we are now coming into areas of the universe that our great ancestors from maybe 250,000 years ago, a couple of million years ago, have visited these parts of the universe, and we are only now revisiting them. And in our revisiting them, we are thinking that there are new planets, and oh, we see this, new this, and new that. It may be new to us because, again, we are at this point in the carousel, and we have incarnated at this point, at this time, where the planet is at this point in the carousel. But to our ancestors, like the Tomoankan, which were actually the Olmecs, and to the Maya who succeeded them, this is nothing new. We've interfaced with all types of different life forms from different parts of the universes that we've encountered. And, of course, because their history does not have the kind of calculus, the kind of cosmic calculus that we have put down, they're thinking, oh, well, we found a new planet. We found a new planet here, and this is a new solar system, and this one might have life, and A, B, C, and a third. And it's, all this is all incidental to those who really know exactly what our story really is about. And there's one more thing. A lot of people who have been talking about the change in science from Newtonian to the Oyibo kind of universe that we've been looking to establish, so to speak, superseding Einstein's E equals MC squared with Oyibo's GIJ comma J equals zero formula. It has come now that the scientists are actually looking to how, to the way that the metaphysicians and the occultists began to classify reality, they began to document the universe. And what we found, or what we knew, and what they have now found, is that we are not circling the sun, that we are essentially being dragged behind the sun as the sun is traveling in this carousel of light. And so what we are looking at in this ellipsis, as the earth is being pulled behind us, behind the sun, is this interplay of all these planets that have found themselves inside of this incredible interplay of movement that has become our seasons, that has become the different ways that we see the planets and so forth. And we are now reassessing what reality is, and we are seeing now that the sun is not something that we circle, because if it was moving, how could we be moving faster than it in order to get around it so that we are circling it? It can't happen. Right. So we are now being pulled behind the sun, and that's going to change the context and consciousness of everyone. Since now we see that no longer are we circling the planet, that essentially we are being pulled behind it, and that whatever circling we're doing is based upon the drag vortex that's created by the movement of the sun.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Very good. And I thank you so much for addressing that, because many people, you know, they want to know, they hear a lot of things that are taking place. I also have a question from someone in the chat room that is asking, what are your predictions? And this may kind of tie into what you just said, but what are your predictions for 2012?
Well, there's no predictions. People making predictions are essentially looking at the stars and then just referring back to what the stars' influences represent. We do know that there will be alignments. We do know that there will be a destruction of sort, an alignment of the planet, and maybe an automatic reversal of the poles. Some people feel that there's going to be an artificial reversal of the poles using HARP. So that we could circumvent any natural pole reversals which would cause more cataclysms. There will be an effort to undermine the population rate of the planet, and that we are essentially supposed to be going back into the gold standard. How true that is, we don't know. And again, I've only gotten these conjectures based upon what I see happening. To the commerce and to the